Servant, did I really have to come to this stupid marketplace with you? It smells like common folk here. And why do I have to wear this absolutely hideous garb? I can't show off my gorgeous looks like this. Besides, if these peasants knew I was the first princess, they would be gobbling at my feet, begging me to take their wares. Yes, I know what Father said. It's not like that's really a problem, anyway. I would love if my mere presence were to cause a scene. At least some people would appreciate me then. If they knew who my father was, we wouldn't even need to bring the money. Of course, they would offer up all their goods to me just because I am the princess. Can you imagine it, servant? When I become queen, the entire kingdom will bow to me and bestow their greatest treasures just to be in my presence a little longer. My kingdom will be the most wonderful that has ever existed, filled with worship of their mighty and beautiful ruler. You're just jealous that you won't ever be able to experience the joys of being royalty. But don't worry, because you're Father's most trusted servant. And because you're a bit cute, you will still have a place in my palace. Doesn't that sound wonderful? Huh? Oh, don't worry about that. It's not like a simpleton like you would understand anyway. Why are we even at this marketplace anyway? And why did I have to come with? It's not like there's anything here that we can't just get from the palace. Ooh, what's that? That necklace, it's so gorgeous. It looks so ornate and beautiful. I have to have it. Servant, you brought Father's allowance, right? Good. I want you to buy me that necklace for me. Come on now, there's no time to waste. Someone might snatch it up if you don't hurry up and get it for me. So what if my father told you to get things from a list? I'll just get more money from him for that stuff later. Don't worry. Just hurry up and get me that necklace. Care to repeat that again? That is a good joke. You thinking you can just say no to me? Now hurry along, the clock is ticking. Hey, you can't say no to me. You realize I pretty much hold your life in my hands. One word to Father and I can have you thrown out of the palace, or worse, executed. You might be Father's most trusted servant, but do you really want to test your luck against me? Fine. You know what? I don't need you. Hand over Father's coin purse. I'm gonna go buy the necklace myself, without your help. Good day. I can't believe he really tried to tell me no. A servant, no less. He couldn't even defend himself from getting the purse taken by a mere princess. Maybe he really was useless as a servant after all. Alright, I'm here. Excuse me, shopkeep. I'd like that necklace over there, please. Why, thank you. I do look rather beautiful, don't I? And here's your payment, good sir. Good day. What? What do you mean the bag's empty? That bag was full of gold coins just a moment ago. There's no way it's empty. No, I'm not trying to steal from you. That's preposterous. No, no. Please don't call the guards here. I wasn't trying to steal from you, I promise. I will not stand for this. Not on my pride as your first pri- Huh? Servant? What are you doing here? Did you come back to save me from these bad men? Please explain to them how I had coins in the back just a moment ago. Why, yes, this is my husband. And I'm just so hopelessly ditzy. I'm so sorry, good sir. I'm not very bright. I really did drop all the coins from the bag somehow. I didn't even notice. I wasn't trying to steal from you, honest. Please, sir, don't take away from my own lack of awareness. Yes, Abby, let's go now. Thank you for giving back the necklace for me. It's not like we can afford it anymore thanks to my accident. Thank you so much for understanding. Husband? That was the best you could come up with at that time. And having to act like such a ditz. Ugh. I just want to crawl into bed now and forget this whole day ever happened. Yes, I really messed up trying to get that necklace by myself. Yes, very nearly got hurt from doing it. Yes, I understand this was my comeuppance for being so spoiled. I'm sorry for going off on my own like that. I should have respected your and my father's wishes. Thank you for saving me from that awful situation. I'm going to be honest. I've been a real jerk, haven't I? I should have just been grateful I'm alive after that experience I had. Wanting everything as I've been doing isn't the way to a good kingdom. I can see that now. Mind you, I won't thank you for putting me in danger like that. But you taught me a valuable lesson. And I can thank you for that. But really, what happened to the coins? I could have sworn you jiggled them for me earlier, and the bag was full to bursting. They can't really have disappeared like that. I don't see a hole in the bag either. Huh? When did you do that? I was talking to you pretty much the entire time. I would have noticed if you were dumping the contents of the bag into your pockets. It's not like it matters now, though. Either way, I didn't get that gorgeous necklace, and I doubt that man will want to sell it to us after that whole fiasco. What? How did you get that? You even still have all the coins still left? No. You did not. Did you steal that necklace? You couldn't have. The shopkeep was practically staring daggers at you. The only way you could have pulled that off is if you were some kind of grand thief. No, I refuse to believe you were some kind of master thief before you met Father. You've been my servant for as long as I can remember. You're not even that much older than I. How did you even get to be a servant if you were? Why aren't you in jail? He saw your talents and recruited you on the spot? You can't be that good. Best of your kind, huh? You know what? I've had it up to here with this story. You really want me to believe you? Prove it. Prove you're some kind of grand theft. Right here and now. What are you doing? Oh my god. You're gonna get down on one knee? And what's that? Such an ornate box. Could that be a ring? Oh god. I'm so confused. I don't know what to say. Could you really be trying to? Wait, how does this prove you're a grand thief? What did you steal? What, did you steal that ring? You'll have to do a lot more than that to impress me. Look closer. All right. But I don't see what this has to do with. There's no way. This has to be a fake. You can't have really. Did you steal the royal family ring? My father hasn't taken it off since his coronation. And he said the only time he would take it off would be when he deemed me fit for the throne. There's no way there was an opportunity to commit a theft of this magnitude. He made you a bet that you would try to steal his ring. If he won, you would serve him for the rest of your life. But then what was the condition for you if you won? You wanted my hand in marriage? Why did you think I would ever agree to that? You didn't. You just wanted his blessing to ask. Well, at least you aren't a complete scumbag, after all. Not many folks these days that ask the woman themselves to marry. They often just ask the women's fathers and don't consider our feelings at all, much like my many suitors. You want my answer? Well, to be honest, I don't. You know what? No, I won't marry you, and you won't be my consort. Until you buy me a real ring. I really had you there, didn't I? You looked so sad just then, like I tore your heart from its socket. Sorry for scaring you like that, but it was just the perfect opportunity to get back at you. By the way, I can easily find out if you stole the ring you gave me, so I wouldn't try it if I were you. But until then, I'm not going to marry you, nor will I accept the family ring until you do. Now then, I wonder what you will do. I can't wait to see how you tackle this.
Hi, it's me, Nami. Sorry I haven't uploaded in quite some time, but I hope you enjoy this one. If you like the video, you know what to do. Check out the description for more stuff. Noblesse oblige. Thank you for your continuing service as my subscriber.